Why is my ferritin low, but my iron and iron saturation consistently high on blood tests? I know this is a perplexing question. I get it asked all the time because it just doesn't make sense in our linear thinking when it comes to iron. So when ferritin is consistently very low, but serum iron and transferrin saturation or iron saturation are in, say, the mid to high range, it'd be like a serum iron of 200 plus and an iron saturation of about 50% or higher. There's a few scenarios or possibilities we want to think about. One, this could be iron distribution rather than true deficiency. Ferritin is primarily a storage protein for iron, and low ferritin usually indicates low iron stores. However, if serum iron and saturation are high, it suggests that iron is circulating, but it's not being effectively stored. And this pattern can occur in conditions like chronic blood loss, like heavy periods, GI bleeds, maybe persons on ibuprofen or something like that, and they're constantly losing blood in their GI tract, where the body is constantly using up stored iron because of the bleeds. Secondly, you can have recent or ongoing iron supplementation. If you're taking iron supplements, serum iron and transferrin saturation can rise temporarily, even with a heavy steak meal. But ferritin, iron storage, it takes a long time to build that up. Some people absorb iron really well, but they don't store it very efficiently, which could create this low ferritin, high iron saturation situation, which is very acute though in that circumstance. Third, you can have iron dysregulation or transport issues. Iron loading conditions like, say, early stage hemochromatosis can cause high serum iron and high iron saturation, but low ferritin in some cases. I see this most often in people who are donating blood but have hereditary hemochromatosis. High iron saturation, low ferritin. There can also be dysfunctional ferritin synthesis. Somebody's got a genetic variant where they just do not create that protein very well. This could cause ferritin that you see in the blood to not reflect the actual total body iron accurately. Number four, consider your heavy metal burden. I would especially be looking at cadmium or lead toxicity, as these can definitely interfere with iron storage and iron utilization. And number five would be bone marrow. Do you have some blood cell disorder? Some bone marrow disorders or conditions like hemolysis, say like where there's excess breakdown of red blood cells, can actually cause high serum iron and high iron saturation, but there actually could be inadequate iron storage. And this is another time where basically the iron is getting used up. Right, then number six would just be nutrient depletion. I'll talk about this in some other videos, but copper, vitamin A, zinc, magnesium, these are the most common ones. These deficiencies in these nutrients can really impact ferritin and iron metabolism. It can make blood levels like crazy, you could say, or out of control or perplexing, even though you may be doing everything you think you should do to help raise your iron levels. Okay, so say maybe this kind of stuff, you're wondering, like, is this going on? What's going on here? A few things you want to check out. I would check your total iron binding capacity. I always check that every single time I run a ferritin level. And if total iron binding capacity is low, it suggests the body isn't trying to grab more iron. And that very much could be an iron load state you're in, and you wouldn't want to just keep taking iron. If it's high, it suggests your body is in need of more iron. It wants more iron, and continuing with iron is probably a good idea. If you're taking iron supplements, I would consider stop taking them 4 days before your blood test, and then recheck your ferritin, your iron saturation, your serum iron levels, your total iron binding capacity, and just see where they're at. Because it could just be that acute iron input that's actually causing you the issue with the high iron saturation on your blood results. The next thing I would check is your site count and CBC, put them together. And this will help you see if there's excessive red blood cell turnover that might be leading to this interesting low ferritin, high iron saturation. And I would assess for GI bleeds, menstrual loss, or you're just chronically losing iron, which could lead to low ferritin, but the body's like, we got to get iron to places we need it. So then the iron levels, serum iron levels in the blood, the transportation of iron is actually elevated. And then finally, if you're not really coming to any answers, definitely consider just doing the genetic test for hemochromatosis. If there's a family history or you just have unexplained high iron, I would test for hemochromatosis. And then finally, get urinary heavy metal testing done or even whole blood heavy metal testing done to see, where that cadmium's at, where the lead levels are at. Could those be an issue? All right. Thanks for your questions. Keep them coming. You know, if you made any personal discoveries in your iron deficiency journey, man, I'd love to hear about them. Go ahead and put them in the comments below. And I read every single one of them. And I try to comment on every single one of them as well. All right. Talk to you guys and gals later.